Okay, hey, my name is Regan, as you all probably already know. And before I get into the nitty gritty portion of my talk, I just wanted to ask you guys to list three things. Really simple, really quick. Three things that you love. And they can be the most ridiculous things to anybody else, but all that I care about for the purpose of my talk is why you love them. Okay, got those three things? Cool. So if you were to ask me to list three things that I love, then I would say my family, my life, and the ocean. My family, because I don't think there's a group of people that understand me better than my family does. My life, because I believe that it's the best one that I could have been given, and that everyone should live their life every single day, appreciating every moment, whether it be good or bad. The ocean, because it's the one piece of nature that I think humbles me the most. To be able to stand on a beach and look out at the vast sea and know that you are one singular person in a world made up of 71% water, which is pretty amazing to me. So as you've probably guessed by now, I'm going to be talking about love, but more importantly, how we can change the world through love and listening. So why love, you might ask? Because I believe that love is one of the most powerful emotions that a human being can experience. Because for some really strange reason, love has the power to drive people to do things that they wouldn't normally do or feel. So to prove how powerful love can be, I'll tell you guys a little story. So a close family friend of ours passed away a couple months ago, and his family, they were sort of mentally preparing themselves for what seemed to be fairly inevitable. And he was pretty old and fragile, so that's kind of why they were expecting it, and he wasn't really doing very well. And one day he told them that it's okay because he's going to go and see his mother now. Now, that may sound completely sad and depressing to anyone else, but for him, it brought him this overwhelming sense of peace. Now, if you think about it, love that he had for his mother is the emotion that was able to give a man who sort of knew that he was dying a lot of tranquility and peace in his final days. So if that's not proof of how powerful love can be, then I don't really know what is. So maybe, just maybe, if we had a little bit more of this kind of love, not necessarily romantic, but just pure love for everyone, then, you know, we could end a lot of fights against, you know, people of different races, of different religious beliefs, of different sexual orientations. People wouldn't be getting gunned down in the street because of the color of their skin. A video of a child bloodied in the back of an ambulance in Syria wouldn't have gone viral, or better yet, wouldn't have even happened. People wouldn't be trying to ban transgender troops from serving in the military. And people wouldn't be stopped at the airport for looking like a terrorist. And unfortunately, most of us know what that means. So, all of this stuff has either happened or continues to happen in 2018, guys. Like, I feel as if we should have moved on from this, and I'm sure you guys feel the exact same way. I mean, slavery was abolished 152 years ago. The Holocaust ended 73 years ago, and apartheid was abolished 26 years ago. So why are we still fighting? And more importantly, how do we stop it? Do you want to know what a teenager thinks? Love. That's the solution. And although it sounds completely simple and, you know, like a really weird, simple thing that could possibly end all of this fighting and suffering, like Chris Jammie said, who's an American poet, he said that love is one of those topics that plenty of people try to write about, but not enough do. And that's so true. If we could just learn to love each other, irregardless of our race, religious beliefs, and sexual orientation, then maybe we could finally learn to live in peace. And we could stop fighting over these things that we should have learned to stop fighting over a long time ago. So how do we learn to love everyone? I believe that it starts with the older generations teaching the younger generations about love and listening, which is something that my parents did with my sister and myself forever, and they continue to do, which allows me to stand up in front of you guys and preach love. Showing your family members and your loved ones how much you love them every single day, whether it be through your actions or through your words. Not only do we need to teach kids the importance of love, but we also need to teach them the importance of listening. Because nowadays, it's way too often that people just assume that what they believe is Bible and gospel truth, and they don't have to listen or even consider what other people believe. And this is such a poor way of thinking, because it's the same reason, the fact that we don't want to listen to each other is the same reason why we keep on repeating this vicious cycle of hurt and segregation. We need to be open to learning what other people believe in order to accept them. Enrich our minds by listening to people who share completely different views from us. A person who does this is Trevor Noah, who's a South African comedian and the host of The Daily Show. Now, he's had tons of people on his show that share completely different views from him, including a woman named Toni Lauren. And for a lot of people, they see her as a racist. So when Trevor brought her onto the show, there was a lot of controversy over it, because they didn't think that people that shared different views could sit down and talk to each other, or even should sit down and talk to each other. But Trevor and Tomi did it. They sat down, they listened to each other, they shared their views respectfully, no arguing, no fighting, just listening. And now, this might not have changed anything, but the point I'm trying to make is that we will never learn to listen and love each other if we don't try, and if we don't step out of this bubble that makes us so ignorant to what other people have to say and what other people believe. So I urge you to teach kids that are younger than you about love and listening by actually going out and doing it yourself. Because they will go on now to teach their children, and their children will teach their children. And maybe someday we'll live in a world where people won't be scared to listen to what other people have to say, and will really try to understand each other and to accept each other and to love each other. So that's pretty much it. Love and listening. That's the only piece of wisdom that I can impart to you guys, but for me, it's the most important. I don't want to live in a world where hatred and violence is chosen over love, and neither should you. Of the past 3,400 years, we've been at peace for 268 of them. 108 million people have died over, you know, fighting in a war about race, religious beliefs, or sexual orientations, or they were just in the wrong place at the wrong time. We have to stop this. We need to do better. We need to be better. We need to try harder. So I challenge you guys, when you finish this video, to go out and to do something today and for the rest of the days of your life, where you truly feel that you've put a bit of love back into the world, whether it be through a very large act or something that's very small and simple. It doesn't matter. All that I need to know is that you guys are trying. Because I don't want to be the generation that just sits back and watches as all this terrible stuff happens to people. I want to know that we are actually doing something, that we are trying our very best to make the world a little better. So we can't undo past events. Right? I understand that. But what we can do is we can try to understand each other, we can try to listen and learn to love each other in hopes of making the world a better place. Thank you.